Hey guys, Kevin here, and today I'll be showing you a basic color organ circuit I found from Make. So recently, I have found myself wanting not only a sound immersing experience in my home sound system, but also a color immersing experience too. This has led me to seeking out the circuit by Aki the LED artist. I'll include his amazing LED art and work in the description. Going to the circuit, we can see that there are four basic parts: the mixer slash preamp, the high range, mid range, and low range filters. The mixer circuit combines both audio channels and feeds it to the 2N3904, which then amplifies the signal. The amplified signal is then fed to all the filters. If the amplified signal is fed to the high range filter, for example, only frequencies above the cutoff, which is 2.5 kHz, are allowed to pass, allowing to turn on the 2N3906, which then turns on the LEDs. This is true for the other filters as well. For the mid-range, the cutoff is between these two numbers, 2.5 kHz and 120 Hz. And for the low range, anything below 120 Hz is allowed to pass. This filtering action can be better seen in this graph. As you can see, this is the low-pass filter, band-pass filter, which is the mid-range, and the high-pass filter. And the low-pass filter, anything below 120 Hz is allowed to pass, and then anything above it will slowly decay. This is true with the bandpass filter as well. Anything below the cutoff low for the bandpass filter will decay, and anything above the high cutoff will decay as well, and anything below the cutoff for the high pass filter will decay as well. There's a great Afrotechmods video discussing how low pass filters and high pass filters work, and the basic principles and theory behind them. I'll include them in the description, and also, as you can see in the iCard right now, you can click on it and learn more about low-pass and high-pass filters. Anyways, enough theory, and let's start building the circuit. To build this circuit, you will need the following bill of materials. You will need one 180-ohm resistor, one 270-ohm resistor, two 1K resistors, two 10K resistors, three 100-ohm resistors, and four 2.2K resistors. For capacitors, you will need the following: one 10 nanofarad capacitor, one microfarad capacitor, one 10 microfarad capacitor, and two 47 nanofarad capacitors. For diodes, you will need one 1N4148 or similar, two red LEDs, two yellow LEDs, and two blue LEDs. You can always switch out the colors for these LEDs. For transistors, you will need the following: one 2N3904, three 2N3906s. These can be swapped out for any other transistors as long as they have the following properties as these. For reference, here is the pinout for these two transistors. Emitter-based collector for both. And for miscellaneous, you will need the following materials. You will need one 9-volt battery, one 3.5mm jack, and one breadboard. These are all the materials we will need, and in the following clip, there will be a time lapse of me building the circuit.
Thank you. Hey guys, Kevin here. I just finished building the light organ. So I'll demo to you right now, and as you can see, my setup is basically the light organ, which is then connected to this audio splitter. And then that audio splitter is then coming from this stereo cassette player, and I'm using the radio on it. And then as well, I'm connected to a speaker from the audio splitter, so you guys can listen to the music while I play it. And so I'll turn on the radio right now, and... So, this is the low end, this is the mid-range, and that's the high end. And as you can see, it's working very well. Let's turn up the volume a little bit more. Let me just turn off the lights. Guys, I'm going to turn off the radio now, and let me just bring back the light. This circuit was really fun to build. I hope you guys are going to build this in your house. It was really easy to build as well. It took me about an hour and a half. It only requires about 30 parts. The only thing that was kind of hard for me to find, as you could probably see in the time lapse, was that diode right there. I had to take it from an old, video player, I believe. Anyways, this circuit was fun. I've had fun building it. I'd probably make this into a PCB to eventually add this to my sound system. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace out. Seven.